Several special considerations need to be made for a pregnant patient in cardiac arrest. First, the goal is to focus on high-quality CPR, oxygenation, defibrillation, and ACLS medications for the mother. By saving the mother's life, the baby has a greater chance of survival. In addition to a priority on the mother's care, there needs to be one person available whose only responsibility is the care of the newborn. Now, because pregnant patients are more likely to have hypoxia, it's vital to place a high priority on oxygenation and good airway management during resuscitation. Also, because of potential interference with maternal resuscitation, fetal monitoring should not be attempted during cardiac arrest. Compression on the mother's arteries and veins from the baby in the abdomen can impede venous return and decrease cardiac output. To help relieve compression on the mother's abdominal aorta and inferior vena cava, left lateral uterine displacement should be done with one or two hands by pushing or pulling the abdomen to the mother's left side. We also need to consider that initial efforts for maternal resuscitation may not be successful, and preparation for perimortem cesarean delivery should begin immediately. Ideally, perimortem cesarean and delivery should be done during resuscitation efforts within 5 minutes after maternal cardiac arrest. When the baby is born, inflation and ventilation of the lungs are the priority. If an infant is born with meconium-stained amniotic fluid, routine endotracheal suctioning for both vigorous and non-vigorous infants is not recommended. Endotracheal suctioning should only be done if airway obstruction is suspected after providing positive pressure ventilation. A rise in heart rate is the most important indicator of effective ventilation and response to resuscitative interventions. If a newborn infant needs vascular access right after birth, the umbilical vein is the recommended route. If IV access is not feasible, it may be reasonable to use the IO route. With pregnant patients, it's especially important to consider and treat reversible causes of arrest to give the best chance of survival. In addition to the H's and T's, common causes of maternal cardiac arrest are hemorrhage, heart failure, amniotic fluid embolism, sepsis, aspiration pneumonia, venous thromboembolism, preeclampsia and eclampsia, and complications of anesthesia. To achieve the best outcomes, healthcare systems need to conduct team planning with obstetrics, neonatal anesthesiology, intensive care, emergency, and cardiac arrest services.